for what's right. Fight for your life. When it comes crashing down and it hurts inside,
you got to stand. Well, this isn't anything about any other country but America. Because it's time for us to stand up and be heard as a people. It's time for the world to stand up and be heard as a people. But mainly we're talking about right here in America. Because you hurt my pride, you hurt our pride by insulting our virgins. Now it's time to stand up for our rights. Stand up and fight for what's right. Fight for your life. It's sad whenever we will allow our government to pass a $500 million bill for freaking horse contraceptives to save horses. $500 million. But we can't even stand up for that. I gives a damn about a horse whenever us as people, human beings, living, breathing people of this society can't find a fucking job. Excuse my colorful metaphor. But there's no other way to put it. You're worried about a horse? $500 million for a horse condom? But you can't pass any of that money along to the small business person that's trying to employ more people, that's trying to gain more business. 70%, if not more, of America's employment is by small business. And if they pass these rush through Barack Obama plans, small business will no longer exist. Maybe that's what they want. And if it is, I'm out of here. I give up. If my voice cannot be heard as a person of this country, I'm going to go to one where it has a voice. But until that day comes, I will stand up for what's right. I will fight for my life here in this country, because as long as we voice to the government, we still have a chance. We need to go to our local representatives, which I have. We need to go to our senators. We need to go to our congressmen. We need to send them letters. We need to call them. We need to boycott. We need to protest in front of their offices peacefully. And let them know, don't do this. Don't buy into the okey-doke just because you're a Democrat and he's a Democrat. This has nothing to do with Democrats and Republicans and independents and conservatives and liberals. It has nothing to do with that. It has to do with the rights and liberties and the Constitution of the United States. Can't you see this? Now, I'm not going to make this too long of a video, and I always say that, and it'll end up being an hour and a half. I'm probably going to do a live show on this and have a round table discussion of my own with whomever I have there, both in the chat rooms and with me. I don't know if I'll be over at Kid and JP's house or not doing that, but yeah, we're probably going to do a live show on this matter, and I want people not just to send emails, but I will forward those on. I would prefer to have video responses from you out there, whether it be one of those little movie maker text responses, voicing your opinion on it. Let's keep it clean and let's keep it professional so that they know. And I don't care what age you are. If you could be 10 years old and part of the Craft Chest Nation, you're still a citizen. All right? I don't care where you are in the world. If you're part of the Craft Chest Nation and you believe in what's right and you believe in the Constitution of the United States and you believe in freedom, send a video response. Leave a comment. And we will forward that on and let our voices be heard. We can compile. We can gather an alliance for the United States and let Barack Obama and the rest of government know. You work for us. But in the meantime, we need to keep in mind for future reference the next 2 years, the next 4 years, the next five, the next six. The next time elections come up, it's time to not vote a name. It's time to not vote parties. It's time to vote in the people. The common man is what this government was set up to be, for the common man, not for big oil, not for big business, not for big finance, not for for all these other bigwigs up here that have interest overseas. We need to have the common man back where they belong, which is in government. You don't have to be rich, and you don't have to go to Harvard to hold an office. You don't have to be crooked. You don't have to take under the table bribes and all this other stuff to be in office. It's your fault out there. Along the line, I've made a couple of decisions voting for people that I probably shouldn't have either, but, you know, I bought into a couple of okey-dokes myself. But it's time for us to actually see everything that they stand for before we elect them in office. It's time for the old, good old boy mentality to go to the wayside. All that old blood that made this country what it is today is our problem. And we continue to vote these honyacs into office. It's time to vote them out of office and get some people in here that actually care. The common man. The person with a little bit of common sense that believes in the Constitution of the United States. It's not a living, breathing Constitution. It is the Constitution. Rock solid. It doesn't change. The Founding Fathers never meant for it to. That's number one. And number two. And then we need to continue to pay attention on what's going on. I talk to a lot of my friends and I'm amazed that you don't even know what the heck is happening in your surroundings. I mention every day to a couple of friends of mine, hey man, did you hear about they're doing this or that? What? No, man, that was 10 years. No, that was yesterday. It might have happened 10 years ago, but it's happening again and it's still not good. We need to pay attention on what's going on in our current events. Not just watching MSNBC or PMSNBC, whatever they call it. We need to stop watching Fox and NBC and all these other medias that force one little subject down your throat. You have the means. If you're on here watching this video, you have the most powerful tool on the planet, which is the internet. You can research it if you get off your lazy behinds, no matter what age you are, and find out what's going on in your world happenings. If nothing else, your local happenings, see what's happening. See what's going on in your part of the world. Pay attention. It's just like we learned in the Army. Stay alert, stay alive. But we can't even stay alert enough to worry about staying alive. We're just living, and that's it. But it's time for us to stand up and fight for what's right, fight for our lives. You know, in a peaceful manner, of course. I hope it doesn't ever come to us having to actually stand up against the government. We should be able to stand up with our voices, and that be enough. But that's why, you know, they have the militia part of it in our Bill of Rights. So, I don't know. But folks out there, just keep in mind, support everyone who is against what Barack Obama and the rest of our government is trying to do right now and rush through stuff. I don't care what deadline he has. When has the government ever hit a deadline? When has a corporation, just regular outside of government, when has your place of work ever hit a deadline? Think about it. I ain't never worked for anybody where a company has ever hit a deadline that they expect us to be the perfect little citizens. But they can't hit a deadline to save their lives, much less ours. Now there's, from what I understand, about 1,016 pages of this new bill. And I'm looking for that thing because I'm going to read all of it. I'm going to read it. That's going to be some good reading material. Go soak in the tub, have my laptop, download that, read it up, and see what's going on with it. Because I want to see where the money's going. Because this trillions of dollars can't just be for... what happens when you run out of that? I mean, what happens? You got to go back and dip in for more. It's just, think about it. That money's not going to last forever.